بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم dear students, I am Sahid Noor and welcome to a new lecture of Electromagnetic Field Theory. This is our lecture number 11 of the course and we will start a new chapter from the book. The title name of the chapter is Static Electric Field. Our main topics of this lecture will to cover the topics related with electric field, electrostatic field, and then we will also study the properties of electric field and a well-known experimental law known as the Coulomb law. We will study its validation and the law which is used for free and material medium quite differently, and we will also discuss a few postulates related to electrostatic. And at the final stage of this lecture, we will discuss electric field intensity due to a point charge. So let's start our first topic of the lecture, which is related with the introduction of electrostatics. The study of electric charge interest is known as electrostatics. As we know that in nature, we have two types of charges, a positive charge and a negative charge. And when these charges are at rest, and if we study its property, its behavior, and its attraction and repulsion on another charge, so we will call it the electrostatic. And the region of space around a charge where it experiences a force of attraction or repulsion is known as an electric field. Electric field is a vector field, and it is directed from a positive charge to a negative charge, and it is represented by symbol E. So let's discuss some properties of this electric field. The electric field is represented by electric lines of force, which means that if we place a point charge attached or on these lines, so it will experience a force of attraction or repulsion, and these lines are directed from positive charge to negative charge. So by this property we can say that the electric field is a vector field. And the third property of the electric field, that these lines, the electric lines of force, will never intersect each other. And if the space between the field lines is same, then the field will be uniform. And remember that these electric line of force are imaginary lines, but it represents a real field. So let's discuss some figure of related with the electric field. Consider a positive charge and the region of space which is represented by electric line of force. This region of space is known as electric field, and these lines are originating from positive charge and from positive to negative charge. And you will see that these electric field lines, whether it is between between two charges or a single separate charge, these lines will never intersect one another. And if the space between two adjacent field lines are same, so we will call the field as a uniform field. And consider this figure in which two parallel plates are there and a static charge appear on the surfaces of the plates. So the field will establish between the plates, and the field is directed from positive to negative plates. And it is clear that the field is uniform at the middle of the plates, and at the outer edges it is a slightly outward in the direction, and these are known as the fringes in the field. In this slide we will discuss about discrete charges and its various positions. In electrostatic or in electromagnetism, we will mostly discuss about a point charge. A point charge is a discrete charge and its volume is approaches to zero. So any charges whose volume is approaches to zero will be considered as a point charge. For example, an electron, positron or a proton is called as a point charge. And we also discussed about a test charge, which is used to discuss the behavior and property of our main charge or a point charge. So this is known as a test charge, which is used to study the behavior and property of any other charges. And the magnitude of test charge is 10 to 0. And it, in some book, it is represented by Q naught. And to discuss the field of point charge, we need a reference point, which is known as origin of the field, and where all the three coordinates of the space is zero or zero. As you know that the field is related with the space coordinates, so if all the three coordinates at a point have zero value, so we will call them as a origin of the field. Few other points which is related with the point charge and with the property of electric field. One of them is known as a source point, where the point charge is placed. So it may be origin or some other position with respect to origin. And where the field is to be calculated with respect to origin, so that point is known as a field point. And in figure, you can clearly see that if all the three coordinates have zero values at a single point, so that point will be represented as a origin. So if our charge is placed at the origin, so this origin point is also known as a source point. And we are interested to calculate the strength or the value of electric field which is at a distance r from the origin, and we will call this point as a field point, because we are interested to calculate the strength of electric field at this point. In second figure, we are going to discuss the position of a charge and the position where the field is to be calculated with respect to origin. So here in this figure, the charge is at a distance r prime from the origin, and we are going to calculate the electric field at a distance r from the origin. So the distance between the charge and the field point, or the distance between the source point and the field point, is represented by this symbol. So it is clear that the charge may or may not be lies at the origin. In first figure, our charge, our source point and the origin are the same points, where in the second figure we have three different points: the origin, the source point and the field point. So the charge may and may not be lies at the origin. Now in this slide, we are going to discuss an experimental law which is related with the electrostatics. So we consider that two point charges which are at rest and are separated by the distance r. Then by the experiment, Coulomb observed that the force of attraction or repulsion between two point charges is directly proportional to the product of two charges, and this force of attraction or repulsion is inversely related with the square of the separation between two point charges. And by combining these two equations, which have inequalities, and to make it In the equality sign, we must observe a constant of proportionality. Here, k is a constant of proportionality, and for free space, its value is 9 into 10 is power 9 newton into meter square per coulomb square. And if one two will be positive if the behavior of two charges are similar. So if these two point charges are positive or both negative, so the force will be repulsive. And if these two charges have different nature, that is positive and negative, then we will have a negative sign which will represent the force of attraction. And so this k is known as Coulomb constant, which depends upon another constant, which is known as the permittivity of the material medium or free space. So this, for free space, we will write k is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. As in the introductory lectures of this course, we discussed three constants which are called the universal constant of free space, which are mu naught, epsilon naught, and c. C represent the speed of light, mu naught represent the magnetic permeability of free space, and the epsilon naught represent the permittivity of the free space. And here k depends upon that permittivity of free space. In vector form, is force is vector, so in vector form it can be written as magnitude along with the direction. So the blue expression represents the magnitude of the force, and the red represents a unit vector along the radial direction. Some other quantities related with the electrostatic or electric field intensity, flux density, which are known as the field quantities, and the third quantity which are related with electrostatic is the scalar potential. And we have discussed it when we discuss a curl free vector whose expression can be written as negative gradient of a field. In this slide, we will discuss the first field quantity, which is the electric field intensity. And it is defined as the force per unit charge that a very small stationary test charge experiences when it is placed in a region where an electric field exists and is given by F divided by Q naught. E represents the electric field intensity, and the magnitude of the test charge, Q represents the test charge, and the magnitude of test charge tends to zero. The SI unit of electric field intensity is Newton per Coulomb. And later in this course, we will also discuss that there is an equivalent SI unit of electric field intensity, which is volt per meter. The electric field intensity E is proportional to the force, which means that if the magnitude of electric force is greater, then the electric field intensity will be greater, and vice versa. And it is a vector quantity, its direction also depends upon the direction of the force. And the expression of force in term of electric field is given by QE. And now we are going to write fundamental postulates of electrostatics. The first postulate, which is related with the divergence of electric field, and the divergence of the static electric field intensity is equal to rho by epsilon naught. And the second postulate is related with the curl of electrostatic field. The curl of E is equal to zero, where the rho is known as the volume charge density, and the epsilon naught represents the permittivity of the free space. The second postulate tells us that the electric field are irrotational, While the first postulate tells us that the electric field is not solenoidal unless the rho is equal to zero. These are the differential form of the postulates related to electrostatics. Now we are going to derive an expression for the electric field intensity due to a point charge in free space. So to derive the electric field intensity for a point charge in free space, we will take help from the first postulate of electrostatics, and we will apply a divergence theorem on the first postulate and will obtain our equation. So the first postulate, which is related with the divergence of electric field intensity, and it can be written as rho by epsilon naught, and the rho is known as the volume charge density. First we will take the volume integral on both sides, and the left hand side will be converted into the surface integral with the help of a divergence theorem, and the right hand side, the volume integral of the charge density is equal to the total charge. So our equation will be equal to the surface integral of E is equal to total charge divided by epsilon naught. And for a point charge, the surface element, that is the differential area, which is parallel to the radial component, and we will put the expression for electric field intensity and the surface area element as E r in the direction of a radial vector dot the surface which is parallel to the radial vector. So as we have a dot product between two vectors, so AR dot AR will equals to 1, and we took for a point charge, we took the spherical surface, and for spherical surface the electric field is constant at the surface, because from the center, from a point charge to the surface, the distance is same in all the directions. So ER will out from the integral, and we will take only the integration of the surface element or the area element. And as we know that for a point charge we have a spherical symmetry, and the integral represent the total area of the spherical surface in this case. So the area of the surface is 4 pi r square, where r is the radius of the spherical surface, and we can easily obtain the expression for electric field intensity as E is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into r square. This is the magnitude of the electric field intensity due to a point charge, and in the vector form it can be written as ER. So we make it bold, and on the right hand side we put a unit vector which is along the radial direction. So this is the expression for electric field intensity due to a point charge. R, we are going to find the electric field intensity at distance R from a point charge Q in the direction of the radial vector. And if the charge Q, which is not at the origin and it is at a distance R away from the origin, and the field point, the field is to be calculated at a distance R from the origin, then the above expression can be written as electric field at a point P is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R minus R prime whole square. This is the magnitude part, and the direction of the vector, unit vector in this case, is in the direction of P. So now the charge is placed at some other point than the origin. and we have two position vector, which represent one represent the position of the charge q from the origin, and the other represent the field point where the field is to be calculated. And this the unit definition of a unit vector is vector divided by its magnitude. So for unit vector, we can write r vector minus r prime vector divided by the magnitude of the above vector. So we if we insert the value of the expression for the unit vector in the above equation, our expression for electric field intensity will be q into r minus r prime vector divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into modulus of r minus r prime cube. And from figure it can be seen that our charge, which is q, and it is at a distance r prime from the origin, and we are going to find the electric field at a point P, which lies on the spherical surface, and this is at a distance r from the origin. And we need this vector as well because our charge q is at a distance r prime, and this distance is equal to r minus r prime, and we use the vector calculation to derive this vector. Now, at the last part of this lecture, we are going to discuss a problem in which we have to determine the electric field intensity due to a point charge in air. So, next, we have to calculate electric field intensity at a point P, which is given by minus 0.20 minus 2.3. So we have to find the electric field intensity at this point, but our charge lies at a point whose coordinates are 0.2, 0.1, and minus 2.5. So these points are given with respect to our origin. This is represented our field point, which is represented by distance r, our vector r, and this is represented by r prime. So to find the electric field intensity, first we will find the vectors related to this problem. So the position vector of the field point P, where the field is to be calculated, and for this we are take the bold r, and which is from the origin to that point, and we will subtract the coordinate of origin from the coordinates of a point P. So our vector will be minus ax into 0.2 minus 2.3 az. And the position vector of the point charge q, our point charge is q, which is taken as r prime and is equal to o q vector, and this is the vector form of r prime. But in formula, we need vector which is represented by r minus r prime, and we will subtract the correspondence coordinates of r prime from r, and this will be our vector. And we also need the magnitude of this vector, so we will just take a square of the component of ax and ay and az, and then we'll take a square root, so our modulus will be equal to 0.458 meter per second. And the magnitude of test charge is given as 5 multiplied 10 power minus 9, or a 5 nano coulomb charge whose field is to be calculated for a given point. So by putting the value of K, which is 9 into 10 power 9, or 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, the value of epsilon naught is 8.85 into 10 power minus 12. By calculating this bracket, we will have the value of K, which is 9 into 10 is power 9 newton into meter square per coulomb square. This represents the value of q or the point charge, and we have obtained the vector form and the magnitude form of r minus r prime. By putting the value, we will obtain 14.5 into a unit vector. So the magnitude of electric field intensity at a point P is 214.5 volt per meter, and the term in the brackets represent the unit vector along the direction of the field point. And you can easily see that you can easily calculate the magnitude of this vector. So the electric field intensity due to a point charge at a point P is given by 214.5 volt per meter. So let's summarize our this lecture. What we have studied in this lecture, we have discussed the electrostatic field, a field related to a charge at rest. We have also studied some properties of electrostatic field, and along with the electrostatic field, we have discussed an experimental law which are valid for point charge at rest, and we discussed the electric field intensity for a point charge, and we have derived an expression for the electric field intensity due to a point charge. But first, we have discussed the postulates of electrostatic field, which are the divergence and the curl of a static field. The curl of static field is also is equal to zero, which represents that the electrostatic field is an irrotational field. And first postulate, which is about the divergence of electric field, which is not equal to zero. So it means that the electrostatic field is not a solenoidal field. In next lecture, we will discuss the electric field intensity due to discrete charges or many charges, along with the electric field intensity due to a continuous charge distribution. These distribution may be along a surface or may be in three dimension or along a linear line. And I hope that you will understand this lecture. If you feel any difficulties related to this lecture, you can contact me at my email. Till then, Allah Hafiz.